Site tracking helps you solve some problems when you're working to learn more about your customer. Remember, knowing your customers better makes it easier every time you want to send them a message or do something for them. So that's the big problem, right? How do you know your customer better? But your marketing efforts will always get more effective when you can be specific about the problem you're working to solve. So let's get a little more specific here. What individual problems might you be facing that site tracking can help you solve and help you better know your customers? First of all, how do you know which of your contacts are visiting your website? That would be a pretty useful thing to know, the specific people who are engaged. They're much more likely to be contacts that will become customers. Next, what are those contacts interested in? It's also pretty useful. Site tracking makes note of that, so you can use it later. Again, if you know what people are interested in, you know what you want to talk to them about. You might want to aim your marketing communications at a target. It helps to know what and where that target is. Otherwise, you're shooting from the hip in a dark room, and your odds of hitting the bullseye are, well, they're not very good. And finally, when should you talk to those contacts about the things that you know they're interested in? Using automation, you can send them messages triggered by site tracking data that make the most sense based on who they are. So in short, site tracking lets you create marketing and sales processes that use behavioral targeting, triggered messages, and specific segmentation. What if you're not sure where to start? You start here. Identify a problem that you want to solve, and then think about whether or not knowing which contacts have looked at particular website pages would help you solve that. Check out this quote from Colleen Bowe, the email marketing manager at ActiveCampaign. And for some added context at ActiveCampaign, we use ActiveCampaign. A lot of the information that we get is based on behavioral triggers. So we can look and see if they visited a certain page on the website, trigger an automation, and have that maybe route to sales. Or maybe get them started on a specific path based on the pages that they've gone to. Now let's hear from Sven. What problems was he trying to solve with site tracking?
You, for what I understand, had a very interesting use case for sort of how you started using site tracking. There was sort of a problem or something that you were looking to solve, looking to accomplish. Can you talk a little bit about how you started using site tracking?
Yeah, of course. So yeah, we're about 6 years ahead now since the start. But in the beginning, we were making quite a loss every year, and we were fully in investing mode. So at that time, we needed extra funds, and we decided to do a crowdfunding campaign. And we also decided to do that with our customers and with our taxi partners. So we had a big list and already an active campaign with a pretty big list of our contacts. And we shouted out that we had this crowdfunding campaign. But what we actually wanted to know is like, okay, who is really interested to possibly invest in us, and how can we manage that? Because we can take a look at the open rate or to see, there was not much to see if we don't use site tracking. So what we did, we implemented the site tracking and also used the lead scoring technique to find out who actually not only was clicking on the link, but actually really dived a little bit deeper into our website and to see if they're really interested in possibly investing at our site. And for our sales team that was doing the telephones to actually do the conversation to find out if he or she wants to invest a little bit extra. These are all not the professional investors, but these were all the crowdfunding kind of investors, so our clients and the taxi partners. But because of site tracking, we found out that some people were actually doing much more on the website, and they're getting because of the point system, we were able to make a short list of 200 people that we could see like these are really interested, and we have to call the those kind of people instead of only doing everything by email. Of course we send out emails, but these people were really highlighted as the hot leads for the investing. So this was actually the start of site tracking for us.
That's awesome. So you were sort of, you know, like, for lack of a better term, listening to what they were doing across your website, seeing that they were looking at these pages and diving into your website more and more. And then you identified those through site tracking and lead scoring, you had mentioned, and then reached out to those people.